Hey, what is up, guys? Oblivious here, and today we are going to be doing a Black Ops 4 video. Yes, you heard it here correct. We're actually going to be doing a Call of Duty video on this channel again, finally, and hopefully there's more to come, but we'll get into that later. But yeah, so right now we're just going to be talking about the Black Ops 4 beta. So real quick, right off the rip, the background video is actually just going to be like the beta trailer, probably like a few times over again, or maybe some like other random beta clips or whatever. But I actually haven't had the chance to play it. I'm on an Xbox player, so I actually don't have it until August 10th to the 13th. So I'm literally fiending so hard. I almost bought it. Like, I almost actually like went out of my house today, bought a PS4 just to play the beta. Like, I was gonna like lease it. I don't even like just. I'm just steal one. I'm not really sure about it. But right now it's going on from the 3rd to the 6th just for the PlayStation. And then as I said to the 10th to the 13th is Xbox and PlayStation. And then there's like the whole PC thing. I don't even care about that. If it's free on the PC, I'll play the beta on that too. So that'll be sick. But yeah, so today we're just going to actually be talking about what I've heard so far. I've been viewing like Twitter, Reddit, and other like forms of social media that like have Call of Duty Black Ops 4 content on them, and I've been seeing a lot of good things. I mean, every single year when a Call of Duty comes out, like all the Call of Duty like pros and stuff that I follow on Twitter, they all gas it up, all the casters and all like the old, like all the people who blew up, like who are famous now on like Fortnite and stuff like that, who blew up from COD, like Noah J or whatever like that, and T Martin and all that. No, not T Martin, I don't. Ali A, he's obviously like a COD guy, so like they're all kind of like blowing it out of the water, like saying it's the best fucking game ever. But I actually do think, like from what I've seen, it looks pretty fun. The whole thing with the stim, I'm definitely gonna need to get my hands on, but we'll get to that in a second. But yeah, it just basically looks like Black Ops 3 without like jetpacks, which is sick, because that was a great, I thought Black Ops 3 was a great game. But okay, so the first thing we're gonna be talking about is stim. If you haven't actually heard, I'll put up like a picture of what I mean right now on the screen. But basically it's that as opposed to now where you don't get health regeneration anymore, like it usually takes like I think 5 seconds, like usually after you start taking damage you have to like wait like 2 seconds, and then it takes like 2 or 3 seconds to actually like heal up all the way for your regen usually in all the Call of Duties ever. But now they're doing it, this is the first game where they're doing it so differently, no more health regen. So now you actually have to pop like a stim, but then you have this little like plus sign on the bottom left of your like your HUD, and then if it fills it back up you can keep popping stim. And then stim doesn't automatically bring you back to 150 health, which is like the new HP amount, as opposed to just 100, which we'll get into later again. Yeah, it doesn't immediately just get you to 150, it actually just starts like building up really really quickly. So basically you get to it in like a second or two, which is actually pretty cool that you can actually just frequently pop it. I've heard now that you actually have like the time to kill is a little bit longer, because everyone like actually every character has more health and stuff like that, you can actually like survive gunfights and be smarter about like when you're gonna pop stim and like when to take cover and stuff. So I'm really really excited to actually get my hands on it. I'm gonna be playing the absolute, like I'm literally gonna not do anything for the rest of those days. So we're gonna actually talk about the time to kill, as I already mentioned, but the time to kill in this game is like one of the highest ever in Call of Duty, just because the new health is actually you start with 150 health where you actually have like the little bar, and obviously but there's no regen, I just talked about that, so there's the stim. But now there's also a thing called, I think it's called like ballistic vests, and you get plus 50 as well, just like on every single like time you spawn, and you just have 200 health instead. Yeah, so people are saying it's actually pretty good though, like as I was just saying, where like it's more of like a situational, how like if you can actually fight multiple people at once now if you're like really smart and like situational about it, and like just like use like a strategic like position to your advantage, as opposed to just like outgunning everyone where you all have like equivalent health. The next thing is we're gonna talk about the maps. Not really too much, but I just heard that all the maps, like usually Treyarch makes good games and maps in general. And I've just heard that most of the maps are actually pretty good. Like, World War II, I remember the beta, no one ever said there was a good map, because, like, Point du Hoc was, like, the best map in the beta, and that map fucking sucks. I didn't really, or, like, Gibraltar might have been there, which is, like, an okay map. Yeah, but this, I think, I forget what the one, I think it's called, like, Gridiron, I don't even know what the map's called. Like, people in the Call of Duty community on Twitter and stuff were just saying overall that the maps are really good. Like, I'm definitely gonna make another video breaking this down, actually, when I get my hands on it, but this is just, like, early access, because I want to keep you guys updated, because I'm trying to keep updated myself. The next thing we're gonna talk about is the weapons. So right now it's an SMG meta mostly, because the ARs, I think something is weird with like the sights. It's like I think there's no like reflex sights for some of the ARs, like they're only like a certain aim in, which kind of like throws off a lot of people. And I think they're just like really low mobility compared to like the constant damage an SMG can put out and like the quick damage an SMG can put out. Like there's this one SMG, I don't even know the name of it, but I was watching people just fry with it. It was absolutely crazy. There's actually two weapons in the game that I just want to discuss. So there's a weapon called the Swordfish, which is a tactical rifle. Basically, it's an AUG. It looks almost exactly like an AUG, but that gun right now is by far the most overpowered thing I've ever seen. I've been watching multiple streams, like for like a few hours, like not a few hours each day, maybe for like an hour or two each day, and everyone's just using this gun because it actually just like it, I think it's a 4-round burst, and it literally just one burst everyone. It's like the M8 at the end of like Black Ops 3 when it was just slang, but like even better. And the other weapon that everyone has been talking about is the Rampart, and that's because the iron sights literally remind me when I first saw it of the Scar from MW3, which was like one of my favorite weapons to use ever. When I used like a silencer on that bitch, it was so fun. But the only thing now that people are like I've seen people complaining about is like not every gun offers like the good perks, I guess. It's not good perks, but like the good attachments. With a AR, you want like grip, quick draw, and then some type of like attachment, like I don't know, like a vertical foregrip, so you can like move faster while aiming down sight. But there's like some weapons, like the Rampart, I know is like a 6 sight, but I think the best like attachment it has, I think it's AP bullets, and then it's also high caliber or something like that. So like you don't even get grip or quick draw, like or vertical foregrip or like tac stock or anything. So it's just kind of awful right now, which is kind of upsetting. I wish you could just choose the attachments on like every gun like you can in every other COD, but they kind of changed it up on us. But I can absolutely not wait to get my hands on Black Ops 4. I heard all good things so far, only like a few little like tweaks that could be made, but I heard that also Treyarch was tweeting, David Vondahar was tweeting that they're actually like just already immediately making updates to like, so that next week or like the last few days of each beta are going to be like the best, and they're going to keep updating it. And I'm super hyped about it because I would die for a good COD. Like, I don't know if I'll be able to play it now that I'm in like college because I have to kind of focus on that. But if it's good, dude, I might have to just fail out of college, you know, just play COD for my life. So that's going to be it for me. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe if you're new to the channel. If you're hype, subscribe and leave a like because I'm fucking hype. Let me know how hype you are in the comment section. Have a good day and goodbye.